Hey, Christ Covenant family, it's Blake Rogers and Lou Priolo, and we just wanted to provide y'all with a few updates on some things we're thinking about and praying about during these times. Certainly, we are so grateful for the technologies that we've been able to utilize in order to continue having worship services, in order to continue to have groups. Lou, how's technology been for you?
I'm loving it. I sit in my basement and just talk to y'all, and it's really like, it's about like 93% as good as being there. I really, really love it.
Now that we've jumped off into these tech waters, Lou's been really pushing the envelope. He's even got himself a green screen and some other things. And so one of the things we wanted to do is to encourage all of you during this time, continue to engage with our church family during these times through technologies. If you're not a part of a group, know that all of our groups are still meeting. We actually have institute courses that are going on right now, including one of Lou's that we'll talk about here in just a little bit. But there's a lot of different opportunities for you to continue to use this time of social distancing well. And my prayer for all of you is that you would come through this time more strengthened spiritually than you were before, that your trust in the Lord will be even greater than we were before, and that you would appreciate being with your church family even more so than before. So while we love technology, we also are eager to be with you. And I think these sentiments are something that probably you resonate with as well. And so we are making plans to worship together again. Obviously, our state and government officials are working diligently to roll out a plan and activate plans that help us to reopen the various things that we enjoyed prior to the COVID-19 crisis, and church gathering certainly being one of those. And so Jason and I and Lou, along with all of the elders, we're thinking through various things. We're holding them loosely, but we're making plans to worship together again. And so just wanted to let you know how you can be praying for us. Obviously, we want to create a plan that protects people. We don't want to contribute to anyone being sick. We want to love you well, love our neighbors well, by honoring social distancing guidelines. However, as I mentioned earlier, we do want to meet again. And so we're going to be thinking through these things, presenting some things to the elders. But please be praying for us as we make these plans. Lou, what does the Bible teach us about plans?
It says quite a bit, actually. It says, for example, boast not yourself about tomorrow, for you do not know what a day may bring forth. The heart of man plans his way, but the Lord directs his path. Now, some people think that those kinds of verses forbid us from making plans, especially the one in James. Come on now, you say, today or tomorrow we'll go into such a city and continue there a year and buy and sell and make a profit. Well, it doesn't forbid plans. What he says is you ought to say, he says, you rejoice and you're boasting, and all boasting is evil. What you ought to say is, if the Lord wills, we will live and do this and that. So the Latin is Deo Volente. And so we make plans, but we make plans with the understanding that God can rewrite our plans at any time. We write our plans, you know, preferably according to biblical principles. And then God comes along through interruption and says, you know what, Blake, you're not going to actually do that today. Yeah. I get up this morning not thinking I'd be coming into the collective, but my boss wanted me to be here, so I had to rearrange my plans, you know? And so God, through providence, changes your plans. So the point is, we make plans according to the word of God. We don't hold on to them too tightly, and we just trust God through providence to change our plans. So we're planning to be together. We long to be with y'all, that's right, as the Apostle Paul said, but we have to leave that in God's hands.
That's exactly right. And so please be praying for us as we continue to have discussions, as we continue to talk to our elders about what that could look like as we move into the summer and beyond. We certainly long to be back with all of you. And Lou, you're teaching a class right now called Confronting COVID-19 with Courage. Give us some tips. How can we confront COVID-19 with courage?
I think the thing that I'd like to leave everybody with is the idea of patience and endurance. You hardly ever see the word patience in Scripture apart from trials. Well, we're going through a trial right now, and we have to be patient. But it's interesting the way the two different words are used. Actually, there's more than two. But usually when you see the word patience, it's we've got to be patient with people. endurance has to do with trials. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we're kind of cooped up with our family and our roommates and everything else. And so, like, this is a time when we've got to be patient with each other because, you know, our sinfulness is going to come out a little more frequently because we're under pressure. So we have to be patient with the people that we're living with, and we have to endure the trial until the Lord sees fit to get us out of it. Yeah. But 1 Corinthians 10:13 says that in the trial, God, there's no temptation, there's no trial that's overtaken us, but such as Christians, only applies to believers, such as is common to man. But God is faithful. He'll not allow us to be tempted beyond what we're able, but with the temptation, he'll provide a way to escape that we may be able to endure it. There's that word endurance again. Bottom line is, for those of us who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, our trials are limited in two ways by God. They're limited in scope. He's not going to give us more than we can handle. He knows how much we can take. He's not going to give us more than we can handle without sinning. And he promises to let the trial come to an end. Someday, some way, the trial will be over.
Yeah, no, that's super helpful, Lou. And you may be out there and you're like anxious about how to re-engage with the world in a post-COVID-19 scenario. And I want to encourage you. There's 2 weeks left in Lou's Confronting COVID with Courage class. Would love for you to jump in on that. You can register for that online through our events page under the Covenant Institute groupings. And then also excited to let you know that Ryan West, one of our elders, is also going to be kicking off a Covenant Institute course this Friday during the lunch hour. It's going to be a church history course that will last 1 hour. And I think it's going to be 5 weeks. And they're going to look at the different movements from the Reformation to current church issues. And so highly encourage you to jump on over to our events page to register for that as well. Lou, thanks for joining us for this update. Church family, we love you guys and we're praying for you. See you soon.